and gentlemen, I think it's very convenient for opening government to say that it's better for us to face the devil than we yet to know, right? I think it's just very negligent, because you don't know whether or not the devil is going to be worse and you are able to create another revolution when the new devil is actually coming, right? You'll prove in my speech on why post-revolution, this individual will not be able to actually create another revolution, but even worse, in their side of the house, you're going to create a loop of change, whereas you don't know whether or not the change is actually going to be meaningful, and to begin with, the justified for individuals who are actually protected with the existing system and only be wrong from one specific policy. I have two substantive rationales in my speech. Firstly, why in their side of the house they cannot actually maintain all the collateral damage they're going to have by having revolution? They say it's okay for them in their side of the house because at the end people are really happy and people are willing to vote again and win again. Firstly, it's not going to be like Chen and where you only have 2 days or 5 days revolution. In their side of the house, what you're going to have is the world longer time of revolution for all of the lightness of the Dhanny revolution to you. Why is that the case? Because internally, the revolution is hard in nature. Things like you need to accumulate a lot of military power or people who have the capacity to militarily oppress and go against the government who has also the same capacity of power. It is very impossible in the status quo days of democracy. Why is that the case? Because currently the military and how people are gathering is not like what we used to have when people already accumulate one power and already there's only one figure. Currently, the figure is distracted in a lot of areas. Things like in Indonesia, military is controlled by Wiranto. However, the politician, the policy is actually controlled by people. And also there are a lot of people who don't agree with two of them. It means there's a lot of division inside of the military system, one do not agree with another, one hard to actually have the integration with another. That's why you can accumulate a lot of people to actually create this kind of group that you want to have under side opening government. But second, it's also the inability for a state to control themselves where they need to shut down for a long time, and in that meantime they need to sufficient themselves. If you need to have the resources by yourself, you need to actually suffice the people that are dying because right now war is happening because you need to fight the amount of power. But thirdly, I think it's also very bad in their certain house because the dead bodies on the ground are not for only for individuals who are ready to be Tiananmen massacre victims. These are individuals who don't actually agree with all the protests against all the government system. These are the innocent individuals who initially also like the democratic system of a particular state, the elected members of parliament, but in their side of the house, you want to sacrifice everyone just for the cause of individuals who are unable to right now in any meaningful way, right? It means in their side of the house, the collateral that you need to have is people who do not have the ability to consent to whatever damage that you're going to have in their side of the house. But why are our side of the house is going to be better, right? I think it's lying. The current system cannot be changed. There are two scenarios, one externally and one internally. First, the external system was actually visible for you to create change to one bill and actually can impact a lot of people. Firstly, there's a Western developed democracy that always ensures for the country, for example, to be more democratic. That is why currently what happened in Hong Kong, where government cannot actually shoot people on the ground with a lot of tear gas or even with the bulletproof. This is because America is actually continuously giving the intervention to them. And second, there's also things like investment on trade influence. That's why currently Indonesia has a lot of things that actually harm the relationship with China, even people on the ground hate China, because exactly there's this kind of influence. And also other international financial institutions continuously intervene, such as America and whatnot. But then thirdly, I think the people also have the capacity to actually change the government. Things like politics and bargaining chip on how you always cater to your future needs, and all of this thing can always be made in our side of the house. So in your side of the house, what you need to have trade-off is not that people are ready to have another Tiananmen. The trade-off that you need to have at that side of the house is not a chivalry revolution to begin with, and people are dying because they're innocent, right? In our side, true, it's going to be longer, but it's much more achievable. No thank you. So I think in your side of the house, you're not going to face any meaningful change because at the end, it's unjustified and people continuously die. They need to show less of what to begin with this revolution is going to be successful. Second, substantive rationales, I'm going to talk about the post-revolution because I think opening government does not want to engage in the probability of you having a worse likelihood in your side of the house. No thank you. But look, I think it's very confusing for opening government to just say that there's a systematical issue of the whole Hong Kong system, for example. Because that is not true. Hong Kong's problem is only with China, is that depends what they say. The other system of Hong Kong is rude. Things like democracy, they let the elected parliament, they just hate some communist individuals within it. So in their side of the house, what you're going to do is you're going to say that all system in Hong Kong is cruel. We hate everything, we need to change everything radically because that's how the narrative is going to spread in society instead of just one systematic problem that exists within it. What is very hard? People are gonna see that democracy is the reason wherever there's a communist member inside of the parliament that allows an extradition deal with China and whatnot. Things like right now, you're going to cut ties with every foreign allies because you see that they are gonna contribute your community. These are the worst scenarios that might happen in your side of the house because you're attacking and saying that the whole system is broke. You say that is the bad comparative in their role. But what is the other bad comparative role that you have in their side of the house? No, thank you. Firstly, I think they're very negligent for studies and status matches on how you're going to pick a sectarian. What is sectarian? I think it's very likely that the person, the individual that is initially protected by the democratic system, for example, is going to be the minorities in the future post-revolution life, right? While this is extremely bad, it's invariable. There's just going to be a loop of revolution again and again because some individuals are continuously going to feel oppressed. Some individuals are going to continuously feel dissatisfied with the system. This is extremely bad. I think this is extremely bad because at the end of the day, you don't have a clear parameter on what is the inconvenience that you can actually cater to. What is the inconvenience that you can actually bear? Little inconvenience is gonna always be seen as something that we need to fight for revolution. A little bad government, a corrupt government, we need to change the entire system, we need to go to another war again and again. That is the comparative that we have in their side of the house. And that is the cause that you don't want to live off. Because at the end, not just financially and economically, you're gonna be broke because there's also the government shutdown. But also you're not going to have a systemic change in their world because there's no meaningful government that only worked for 5 years and then you need to change again and again. But what's the importance of this argument? The importance of this argument and why this principle and justified for government society actually do this? Because we told you that some individuals is actually protected. People are just going to fight for a single problem like labor or people are just going to fight for extradition bill because that is the thing that only harm them. True, it harms in a lot of sectors, but exactly this is the only thing, like only extradition bill, only lower wage, right? But not the entire democratic system, not the other military system that actually protect the country. We say in their side of the house, you are unjustly taking people out of their consent. They actually fight for everything in order for you to pass one law that simply actually harm them.